And without mantras, there is no tantra. Tantra as a whole system, we cannot practice if we don't even have the mantras. And without the proper channeling of the prana, without really understanding the flow of prana in different centers, we cannot even entertain the mantras. And sometimes, actually, if you do not know the prana udaya, like the basic text you can start from is Shiva Swarodaya. It's translated in Hindi, translated in English. You can find it everywhere, I'm sure. So Shiva Swarodaya, you will know that how the udaya, the rise of different prana is so essential for the practice of tantra, for the practice of mantra. It is necessary for the articulation, uchara of the mantra to correlate with the particular location, position of kundalini. And it is necessary for even to correspond to visualization, specific images visualized, and they have to be matched, they have to be linked. And it is necessary for even the rituals that are performed outside, but without understanding the antaha, like inner pranic relation to the external mandala, then there is no actual practice happening. So when this type of correspondence with the body inside through the channels of the mandala outside visualized, when one understands this intricacy, then one is actually practicing the one knows the system. And when one fails to understand the intricacy, then there are going to be problems. And you know that we hear so many things about tantra practice, and it is not completely unfounded, because if people randomly pick up nowadays, you know, people honestly, I'm not even making up, people pick up mantras and all these vidyas in Google and say, okay, it does not work. I have been practicing 3 years and nothing happened. And then how did you learn? And then they say, oh, this mantra I got in Google, I just followed everything. You are so lucky nothing happened. It's honestly, that's what I tell them. You are so lucky nothing happened, because really bad things could have happened because you didn't go to a proper teacher. And Google is not a teacher, you know. You can have a lot of information there, but that doesn't mean that it is the teacher for you. So it's not, that is where the lived tradition, you know, that is something many of my students here do not understand, the value of a lived tradition, the value of guru, that amount of value we put in our tradition to a lived master who has experienced these things and who can teach us directly, and who himself comes from the genealogy of teachers. Not like randomly, I was sitting on a mountain and I got all the revelations. I don't want to talk about that, but that was not meant. That was not what it was meant when we talked about tradition. It was not some miracle to happen. It is about the insights. It's about the experiences distilled through generations and generations and explored, experimented by so many sages and rishis and yogis and munis. And that is what the yoga tradition is. That's also what the tantra is. There's a deeper relation in every aspect of tantric text you can explore.